Whether you need to get better video quality for your video calls or for recording videos for social media and YouTube, there's an easier way to achieve this result using your smartphone and a cool app called Camo. Hey everyone, it's Edie here and welcome to my channel, where I help you create videos for your business using easy to use and easy to learn video creation tools. In today's video, I'll share with you how easy it is to turn your smartphone into a webcam so that you can conduct video calls with HD quality and record videos for social media and YouTube. But before we get started, I do want to take a moment to give a huge shout out to Reincubate Camo for reaching out to me about this app and allowing me to access it for free to review and share with you, my audience. Now let's get into this. Camo is an app and software that turns your smartphone's camera into a professional quality webcam and video recorder. To use your phone as a webcam, just follow these three simple steps. 1, download the Camo app to your phone. 2, install Camo Studio on your computer. And 3, connect your phone to your computer with a USB cable. Well, you're gonna get great video quality. It works on almost all the apps that you use, from Zoom to Google Meets to WebEx to OBS, StreamYard, and Slack. You're able to adjust lighting, color, lenses, and more. You can also get instant and continuous video preview. It's plug and play capable, plus so much more. Additionally, they do have some new cool features. In-app recording is one. Camo's in-app recording tools make producing your next video a cinch. You can quickly save a stream, practice for a presentation, or create a new video with just a click. This new feature enables users to effortlessly record high-quality video directly in Camo Studio, as well as apply all of the picture adjustments and presets. Their overlays feature allows you to achieve a much more polished look to your streams, calls, and videos, and you can select from a variety of pre-made overlays, or you can design your own in Camo. Now let's take a look to see how you can use Camo for video calls using Zoom and as a video recorder using Camtasia. This is Reincubate Camo Studio Pro. This is the desktop or computer version of it, and I wanted to just give you a quick tour to let you know what it looks like. So under camera settings, you're going to find the devices that you have already plugged into your computer using your USB cable. Now this one does say Samsung device, and as it says here, launch Camo on Samsung. The device is configured correctly, but you don't see anything. This is my camera. It's actually an older Samsung, so that could be the reason. This is connected. I did everything that I needed to do, but it's still not appearing. So I'm thinking it's either because the model is slightly older. I want to think this is probably like a 6-year-old or maybe 7-year-old phone. But they do also recommend that you use the USB-C cable, the USC-C cable that came with the phone. This is not it. So that could be the reason why this isn't showing, but I just wanted to basically verify that yes, Androids are compatible with this. So I'm going to switch to my iPhone, which is straight ahead that way. And so if I had a longer USB cable, I would actually be able to place it exactly where it needs to be, which is where my HD webcam is. And it would be closer, but it at the same time would be further away from my computer. So that means that I have need to have a longer cable. So I recommend getting a 6 to 10 foot cable, depending on where you want to set up your phone. So the next device would be my iPad, which is this way. So I've just set this up in different locations just so that you can see you can either have different angles or you can use different types of devices. So you don't have to use a phone only, you can also use your iPad, and you can use front or back. I have my iPad actually using the front-facing camera, and my iPhone is using the rear-facing camera. So mode, the other thing that I want you to see is the percentage of battery life that you have left. It will switch based on what device you're using. So I have more juice on my iPad. The next thing is mode. Mode just changes your background. It can blur it out. It can make it look pixelated. It can do a wide variety of funky things. It can give you an emoji face. It can give you emoji hands, as long as you're looking directly in the camera that is selected up here. So in order for this to get activated, I would need to make sure I'm looking at my iPhone, and then I would be able to, let's say, for example, do the emoji face. So I can do the face here, if that's something that you want it to do. But there's a wide variety of choices, so I highly recommend that you play with them and see which ones would fit your specific needs. Next up is the lens. So this, as you can see, is the back of my camera. So you have two choices, either wide lens, which is where it is now, or you can do ultra wide, which gives you a much more wider stance. You can see my entire wall. You can see that I don't have wallpaper going all the way up in the middle because it fell down. You can see the full width of my desk almost. You can see all the way to my door. You can see all of my notes that I have up in the corner. So depending on how wide you need to capture, you can use the ultra wide or you can use wide. Either way, you do have the capability of zooming in. So if you wanted to zoom in, you can certainly zoom in if that makes more sense for you. The other thing that it does is you have the ability to have autofocus on, or you can do a manual focus. And so if you do manual focus, you're just adjusting this line there. Then you have the choice of setting your resolution. I prefer to use everything in 1080, so I would opt to put it to 1080. I don't believe, let me see what's going to happen. Yeah, because this is front-facing does not give you the capability of doing 1080, so it automatically switches the iPad to 720, and then when I go back to my iPhone, it then switches back to the 1080 on my iPhone. For audio, you have the option of being able to capture your audio directly from your iPhone using either camera mono or bottom mono. Now, this is ideal if you don't have an external microphone or if you only have use of your laptop's built-in microphone. But if you don't have one, you do have the option of capturing your audio from your camera. In order to do this, you would need to make sure that you've selected Camo microphone in whatever platform you're recording in. So in this example for Zoom, you would go under settings, and then from settings, you would go to your audio, and then under your microphone, you would specifically select microphone camo. However, to ensure capturing the best audio quality you can, I personally recommend using an external USB microphone. Next up is your frame rate. It does not look like you can adjust this, but 30 is the normal frame rate, so I would leave that as it is. Then you have some presets in terms of saturation, whether you want it to have a grayscale on it or any kind of funky kind of look to your video, you can do that under presets. And then of course you can create your own presets and upload presets to here. On PCs, under post processing, they have watermark, whereas on Mac it says overlay. Overlay is a little bit more robust than watermarks. Overlays allow you to have some pre-made overlays that are already in the platform, as well as you can create overlays that you can add. Watermarks are literally just that. Let me show you what the Camo watermark looks like, and that's basically a logo in the lower right corner. If you want to use your own, what I would do is, say for example you're using Camtasia, or even if you're using Photoshop, make sure that your image is 1920 by 1080 and then position your logo so that it's in the lower right corner, even though I'm going to my left, but it's in the lower right corner, and then size it correctly, and then bring that in. Because if you bring in any other type of image that is not positioned that way, it's going to come straight through the middle of the screen and you're not going to be able to position it anywhere. If you want to rotate, you can rotate your image. I don't need to do that ever. And then again, as I mentioned, you can do zoom. And then over here for lighting and image adjustments, you can set the exposure, white balance, flash level, brightness, hue, saturation, contrast, gamma, and sharpness. A lot of this comes into play if you just need to take a still image. Okay, so that is it in terms of the lay of the land. You can keep this open, or you should keep this open when you're using it with StreamYard or Zoom or Loom or whomever, so that you can switch from camera to camera if you want to. That is totally up to you. So I just wanted to quickly share with you that you can use Camo whether you're doing a Zoom call, if you're in Camtasia, or if you're doing Loom. So all you would need to do is in Loom, you come here where it says camera, and then you can choose Camo as one of your options, Logic Capture, or my web camera. So Camo is available on Loom. If you are using Camtasia, it's already set on Camo, but you can see here that you have the choices again. And then for Zoom, you would need to come to your settings, and then you need to go to video, and then under video, you would need to select for your camera, the camera that you want to choose as the camera of choice for your Zoom calls. So I just wanted to quickly share that with you so that you can see how many options you have when it comes to creating your videos using Camo. Now I will say that for Descript, you are not able to yet use Camo. That is still not available. I don't know if it's going to allow me to share that with you. And actually it might. Let me bring this over and get rid of these for the time being. And when you come here to screen, I'm already recording in Descript, so you're not probably going to be able to see it. But under camera, it has disabled. It does not give you an option. So I just wanted you to see that real quick. All right, take care. You can use it in limited capacity for free, but if you really want to unlock all the features that they have to offer, then you'll need to upgrade to Pro at either $4.99 a month, $39.99 for the year, or you can do it for a lifetime price of $79.99. Now, here are my thoughts on Camo. Camo was created about a year ago with a basic objective in mind: to give individuals like you video superpowers. If you've been following me for any length of time, you'll know that I love using affordable, easy to use, and easy to learn tools that help you create videos, and Camo does not disappoint. Here are some of the pros. To get started, it takes three simple steps. Download the app, install Camo Studio on your computer, and then connect your phone to your computer. You can record directly to your computer. Camo integrates with platforms such as Camtasia and Loom. You can add overlays to give a much more polished look to your videos. You can zoom in and out and switch from wide to ultra wide. The pro version is affordable and frankly worth the price. Now here are some of the cons. Recording to your computer is not currently available for PC users. Accessing the overlay library is only for Mac users at this moment. Looking amazing on video calls is easy with Camo. Just open the app, choose your camera, and start chatting or recording. Now I want to know your thoughts and questions, so please leave them in the comments below. In the meantime, feel free to leave a reaction, share this with someone that you think could use Camo, subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to hit that notification bell to be alerted to new video releases. Ready to get started? Click on the link in the description below and start accessing high definition video quality for your Zoom calls, live streams, and recorded videos. That's all for now. Until I see you in the next video, thanks as always for watching. Take care.